numbers, but not great numbers. save is 14. So that's a wrap here tonight. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, this is Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, find us on Twitter at MLB The Show. For baseball of the AAA variety, as the show brings you coverage from the International League. Tonight, game two of this three-game weekend series between the Charlotte Knights and the Lehigh Valley Iron Pigs. It's baseball, it's the show, and it comes your way next. Alberto Paniagua, Cuban-born southpaw, gets the starting nod. Dan Plesac, what do you got?
Hey, this guy's a fun guy to watch pitch. Not necessarily an overpowering guy. He has an ERA in the low threes. But one thing he knows how to do, he knows how to pitch, and he knows how to minimize damage. If you're going to have an ERA in the low threes in this day and age, you're doing a lot of things right. This guy should be fun to watch in this week.
He's ready. Here's the first offering. Takes a knee-high fastball. Fellows are visiting team as they take the field after a scoreless top half. They come in not exactly setting the world on fire as they've brought five of their last eight ball games.
Yeah, guys, after the first four games on this road trip, they find themselves 2-2, kind of par for the course. But they got to find a way to play a little bit better today, kind of turn the tide and get working in a positive direction.
The 1-1. Swung on and missed for strike number two.
All right, let's take a step back right here. He's down 1-2, three fastballs in a row. There is no way he's throwing it before.
A swing and a miss. He offered it a ball way outside the strike zone for out number two. And with that, here's a glance at the starting lineup for the home squad. What's this club going to need to focus on this evening, Mark?
Well, Matt, one thing that jumps out at me is the fact that this is a modern-day lineup. A lot of swing and miss. But not many
for his second at-bat, Harold Ruiz, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. Here's the first pitch to him. And this one's chopped foul right at home plate. Fairly well out towards straightaway center. Silson on the move. He gets there to make the catch, and that ends the inning. So it's no runs, no hits, no errors, and one man left on base. On down to the top of inning number four. Charlotte's out in front here, 1-0. Ready for another shot now. Harold Reese, he'll lead things off here in this one-run contest. First pitch on its way. There's a strike.
This guy's been on cruise control as we head into the middle innings of this one. And one of the big factors why, how about 80% of his first pitches have been for strikes?
Once again, Harold Reese, he got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time.
It doesn't look very promising so far in this one as we move into the later innings. Down by a bundle, it's time to get some base runners and hopefully a long ball to get them back into this one.
The windup and the 0-1. Skied into straightaway right. Engel is there, and he hauls it in for the first out of the inning.
You might think it's just another win, but it's awful.